Hey, it's Jazz, and this is Wildlife Matters. The fight against wildlife crime is everyone's fight, and it's up to each and every one of us to do our part. Enough with the compromises, the bribes, enough with the palusot. Last episode, we took a look at the RA9147, and in today's episode, we are still going to be talking about that. So if you haven't seen the previous episode, first check that out. But if you have already, then here is what you and I now need to do. Number one, follow the rules. Knowing what the law says is the first step, and observing it is the second. Now that you're aware of the laws that govern animals in our country, you can easily tell what's right from wrong, and you yourself already know what you should be avoiding. And you'll be able to recognize if ever you come across someone who is committing a wildlife crime. Number two, do not buy from the illegal wildlife trade. We've already mentioned why the illegal wildlife trade needs to be stopped in our previous video and why it's a terrible, terrible business. Because if you think about it, if we want to put an end to the illegal wildlife trade, then we have to stop creating a demand for these products. Because if there's no demand, then poachers will stop supplying. Thinking of getting an exotic pet? Make sure that they're not taken from the wild. The law states that when you're keeping exotic animals, you need to have them registered and regularly report to the DENR, or the Department of Environmental and Natural Resources. So please don't forget to do that. If you buy from an illegal source, you cannot register it. So either way, you're breaking the law. If someone offers you a wild-caught animal and says they're just gonna find a way to make it legal, that's still illegal. Or if they say, papapelan ko na lang yan, that's still illegal. And if you're caught, there are consequences. But for your information, there are special cases wherein they allow people to keep threatened wild animal species. But that's if and only if you're gonna be doing it for conservation, breeding, or research purposes. And they're gonna check if you have a facility and all the means to do that. I know that a lot of people complain about having to go through this process because they think that it's a hassle, but trust me, it's not. And it's better this way, because that way, the government can do a better job in monitoring the animals in our country. If you're buying an animal, buy legal. Number three, do not tolerate wildlife crimes. We see it online. We even hear stories about it from friends and relatives. Most of the time, people are even proud that they killed a wild animal or nakahuli sila. But we need to put our foot down and say, this is not okay. Just this morning, I saw someone post a picture of a dead, harmless snake that was killed. This is why education is so important, because it makes you think. Why? It makes you think. How many more? When you're about to kill them, I'm so emotional. When you're about to kill them, they can't scream and say, no, I don't want to eat you, I don't want to hurt you. How many more harmless species are we gonna have to destroy by people who just didn't know? Being educated is the best weapon you have against them. Let them know that what they're doing is wrong. Let them know that there are consequences, not only on them, but on humanity in general, if people like them keep on doing this. And number four, push for better legal enforcement. Let's encourage the government to do a better job in making sure that these laws are implemented. In our previous episode, you'll see that there are a lot of people who post pictures and videos of themselves killing and hunting wild animals. There was a clip we included of a mayor who was gonna give a reward to people who killed cobras. Even a DNR employee who killed a harmless, innocent snake. This is wrong. Nobody is above the law, not even them. Everyone should be subject to it, even government officials. Because what's wrong is wrong. But better enforcement needs our cooperation. We need to create a community of people who will continue this conversation. We need to be vocal about this cause so that everyone, and even leaders, will start to pay attention. Because they'll realize that this is something that truly matters. So as we push for our government to do better enforcement, let's all do our part in fighting this battle. Our battle, together. Because every piece of wildlife matters.